subject of this clip is the Carrier FV as in Victor 4CNF air handler and how to set up the blower performance. While I will have you look at static pressure after you set this up to make sure it is not exceeding what the blower is capable of, we're going to do static later. Unlike everything else, we'll usually get static first, find out what speed it's on, and use a blower chart to figure out what the CFM is. This being a variable speed motor, you tell it what you want it to do, and the variable speed motor will try to seek out that performance. So, going to just give you a little tour of this board, and we're go ahead and talk about the little each of the sections on it. Okay, so right now we're going to look at the auxiliary heat section. You notice you've got zero. Okay, so it's 0 to 30 or 0 to 20 or 15 or 10. So you literally could use any of these speeds that you want. What I'm going to tell you to do is to use the lowest speed that you can get away with. Take a look here on the 0 to 30. You see that 1500? Okay. That 1500, the 1250, the 11, and so forth. That's your CFM if you move this purple wire to the other locations. All right. So what I'm going to tell you is we use 5kW. Does 5kW fall in the middle of here? Yeah, here, yeah, here. I want you to use the one that has the lowest number here that your 5K falls within and put the wire on that spot. So right now, look at where that purple wire is right here. Okay, that wire is on the 0 to 10. And if we had 5 or 10 kW or 8 kW, all right, or this is where we would want to choose to put it. And the reason being, the lower the CFM is, okay, the hotter the electric heat is going to feel. And this whole setting right here is when you put this thing in emergency heat, how hot is that heat gonna feel? That's what this is about. So for y'all, I want you to just simply select to put it on the lowest one, and you have taken care of how to deal with setting your air handler up for the electric heat. Okay, next thing. Gonna look at the AC heat pump size. Well, check this out. This air handler can be put on a 4-ton, a 3.5, a 3, a 2.5. You could put this air handler on four different condensers outside. So you have to select one of these pins and tell it what size is your outdoor unit. So if we had a 036, this wire should be right here. Okay, that's where that wire should be. We have to move it. Do not leave this thing in the factory setting, my God. And it's a common problem we find. People don't adjust the blowers. And then we get complaints that the units are not dehumidifying. Well, they're not going to, and you're jacking a bunch of air through it. You didn't do the basic setup. All right. So always set the pin there for the size of the outdoor unit. Okay. Going to move on. Next line, okay, is system type. All right. So what do we got? Do we have a straight cool unit? That's what AC is. Or do we want to set this up for, it says HP right here behind this. Do we want to set it up for heat pump comfort or heat pump efficiency? Right now, what color, where's that orange wire at? It's on heat pump efficiency. I want to explain what you should be putting these on. I want you to put it on heat pump efficiency, but more importantly, I want you to understand why. The carrier air handlers are set up from the factory, okay, with a predisposition towards 350 CFM per ton for cooling. In the heat pump efficiency mode, that is what you're going to get, is 350 CFM per ton for heating. And I'm going to show you how to bump this up to 400 CFM per ton in just a little bit. But I want y'all to go ahead and know, heat pump efficiency is going to give you 350. And the question is, well, what's this comfort going to get you? It's going to get you 315 CFM per ton in heating. Lower airflow. I want you to think about this. When you have lower airflow in heating, is your air coming out going to be cooler or hotter? It's hotter. So lower the amount of air coming across it, the heater can make it, you know, even hotter feeling air. In this case, the indoor coil is the heater. But there's a reality of that. Yeah, oh yeah, this heat pump feels nice and hot now. You turned it down to 315. Got it. But there's a downside to that. What happens to head pressure when you lower airflow in the heating mode? The head pressure goes way up. All right. And when the head pressure goes way up, what do you think that does to the amps on the outdoor compressor? If the compressor has higher pressure, it means it does higher work. It does more work. It raises the amperage. So you pay the power company to for the additional amperage for that compressor to fight the lower airflow. Okay, fight the higher pressures from lower airflow. I don't want that. So heat pump efficiency is where we want you to set it. All right. And that's for the system type. So we have a heat pump and we want it on efficient. Right where that orange lead is where I want you to set them up. Okay. All right. Next thing. This one is where the factory normally has this black wire. It's usually over here. So what we're saying here is air conditioning and heat pump CFM adjustment. I know you can't see it through the drawing too well, but we'll get past that. AC and heat pump CFM adjustment. And what we're looking at is nominal means you're going to get 350 CFM per ton for cooling. And if you set this over here, you're going to get 350 CFM for heating. What happens if you put it on low? Low lowers that 10%. So 350 minus 10% is 315. Well, I certainly don't want that. I don't want less air. I don't even want the 350 CFM per ton on our new construction startups. We can talk about the benefits of 350 later. There's a time and a place for that, but we design at 400 CFM per ton for new home construction. So we're going to pursue that. So right now we know that the minus 10% is going to get us 315. All right. What about this high over here, Alan? What's that going to do? Well, that high is going to add 15%. So my question for y'all is, with that $800 calculator, what is 350 plus 15%? Go ahead and do that on your phone. All right. 350 plus 15%. What's that going to wind up being? I'm actually doing it on my phone right now because I shouldn't do it in my head. None of us should, because it's too easy when we're hot to make a mistake. So we got 350 plus 15% equals 402.5. Okay, you reckon that 402.5 is what we wanted? We wanted 400, right? So my point to y'all is, on new construction startups, we recommend that you go ahead and see where that black wire is right now. Oh my God, it's on high, isn't it? It's on high because this is where we teach people to do it. It's on orange up here because we want our heat pump in the heating mode to bump its airflow up from 315 to 350. Plus, we've got it on high here. Guess what? This is at 402.5, just like the cooling is. And we had you set the outdoor unit size to the correct outdoor unit. And we had you set it up for the proper electric heat. All right. So where we got now, where are we at? We're going to go ahead and look at down here, on-off delay. In my opinion, any off delay is the devil in Florida. Any blower off delay is the devil in Florida. And the reason being, when the thermostat said, hey, you set me for 74. I'm at 74, so I'm shutting off all the equipment there, Mr. Reed. Okay, great. You're the homeowner, right? So you go ahead and it shuts off the outdoor unit. But guess what? If you've got a 90, and if you have a delay in the off is the second half of this line. On is up above the line. That's this 0 and this 30. So if you have any delay off, you are going to have a outdoor unit shut off, but the indoor unit is, the coil is wet and the blower's still running. And it's going to re-evaporate the moisture that's on that coil and put it right back in the house and make it feel humid. So this one and this one are not an option. Where do you see the white wire at right now? 0 and 0. That's where I want you to put it. We're going to leave the explanation of enhanced to another video. I don't want you to use it on startups. If we go back for service calls where there is humidity problems in the home, after we've checked out the entire system to make sure that it's right, we might choose, under the right conditions, to use that enhanced function. I'll discuss it in a later mode because it can help with dehumidification. But we don't want to go there on a startup. I simply want you to set it on 0 and 0. Last item. Okay. Down here, you see a continuous. What they're talking about there is when you switch your fan from auto to on, what speed do you want the blower to run at just for the fan? So what we recommend is to, if it isn't already on it, make sure you put it on low. All right. This concludes how to set up the blower on the Carrier FV4CNF air handler.